Today I'm going to teach you how to solve a Rubik's Cube in 8 simple steps. The first step is to make a yellow daisy. And what we're going to do here is put 4 white side pieces around a yellow center. So we look for a side piece like this, and we bring it into place. And then we find another side piece, here's one, bring that into place. Here's one, we can bring that into place. And then the last one is on the bottom, so swivel it to line up with where we want it, and then rotate 180 degrees. And now we've made a daisy. The next step is to make a white cross. And what we're gonna do is move these 4 petals onto the flip side around this white center. And to do that, what you do is you line up the color on the top with the center piece. So in this case, we want to bring the blue center over here, and then we rotate the face 180 degrees. And then we do that for the next center. Just bring this to red, rotate 180 degrees. Over here, we rotate the orange center and swivel 180 degrees. And then this one's already lined up with green, swivel 180 degrees. And then you flip it over and you see you've made a white cross. And the white cross is aligned with the center colors. Now the third step is to put white corner pieces into place around the white cross. So you're going to look for a white piece on the bottom row. That's the optimal place to work. And you're going to look at the 2 colors that are next to the white piece. So in this case, this is orange and green. So we're going to swivel this to be between the orange and green centers, and it's already in place. So working from here, we're going to try and bring this piece up here. And to do that, you move away from where you're trying to go, bring down the left column where we're trying to put it, bring the piece back, and then rotate it into place. And now we've placed that corner. Now we look for another white piece. Here's one that's got red and green on it. So we swivel this to be between the red and green centers. And we're going to want to put this piece up here. And so we rotate it away from where we're trying to go, bring down, in this case, the right side, bring our piece back, and then rotate it into place. And now we've placed that corner. And now this white corner has blue and red, so we swivel it between the blue and red centers. And again, we're going to swivel it away from where we're trying to go, bring down the left side, swivel our piece back, and then rotate it into place, and we place that corner. So now we look for another white piece. We don't have any more on the bottom layer, so now we're going to have to work with ones that are on the top layer. And so you have to do an extra step here to bring this white piece down to the lower level where we need it. So you do a swivel, you turn the face clockwise. So now this is on the bottom. You swivel it out of the way, and then you bring back your white side. So you've got your cross back restored. And now you've got this white piece down in the bottom layer where you wanted it. And so, and this is in between where we want it. It's between the blue and orange, so it's in the right spot. And so what we're gonna do is swivel it away from where we're trying to go, bring down the left face, the left column, swivel back our piece, and then bring that white column into place. And now we've put that corner in the right place. And then the final piece is actually down here on the bottom. And so what we do is we center it below the hole that we're trying to place it. What we do is we're going to rotate down, swivel 180 degrees, bring in this piece now where we want it, bring this back, and then we place this like we would normally do. So we'd find that we want it between blue and orange, so here, and we're going to swivel away from our destination, which is here, bring down the left side, swivel our piece back into place, and then rotate. And now we've solved the top layer. The next step is to solve the second layer. And what we're going to want to do there is to bring side pieces from the bottom, for example, this one blue and orange, and put them between the centers where they belong. So the blue and orange is going to go here. So for example, what we do is we take this blue and orange piece and we line it up with the blue center like it already is. And then you're going to rotate it away from where it's trying to go. So rotate away from orange, bring down the right side, bring our piece back, bring up the right side, and then we're going to place this white piece like we just did in that previous step where we want to bring it here, and so we move it away from our destination, bring down the left side where we're trying to bring it, bring back our piece, and then rotate it into place. And so now we've got our orange and blue side piece where we wanted it. So we find another piece that needs to be put in place. And so here's an orange and green one. It's already lined up with the orange center, so that's good. We're going to rotate away from green, which is on this side. So rotate away, bring down the right side, bring back our piece, bring up the right side, and then we place our white end piece, corner piece, like we normally do, which is move it away from where you're trying to go, bring down the left side, bring back our piece, bring it into place, and now we've placed that side piece. So now, let's see, here's a piece, blue and red. We're gonna swivel that to line up with the blue center, and then we wanna swivel away from red, which is over here, so move away from red, bring down the left side, move back our piece, bring up the side, and then place the white corner like we normally do, which is move away from our destination, bring down the right side, bring it back, bring it up, and now we've placed that side piece. Now here's a situation where our side piece is inverted. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pretend to bring in the wrong piece. So in this case, we'll pretend we're bringing this piece in. So we move away from where we're trying to go, bring down the left, bring back our piece, bring up the left, and then place the white corner in the normal method. Okay, so now we put this wrong piece here temporarily, but now we go find our red and green piece, and this time we're gonna place it the right way. So swivel up with red, set with the red center, and then we're gonna rotate away from the green center. So rotate this way, bring down the left side, bring back our piece, bring up the left side, and then place the white corner our normal way, which is to move it away from our destination, bring down the right side, bring it back, move that up, and now we've solved the second layer. Now our fifth step is to make a yellow cross. So you flip over to the yellow center side, and you're gonna have a situation where either you have a yellow dot like we do, you could also have a situation where you have a yellow L, which would be having three pieces like this. You could have a yellow line, or you could already have a yellow cross. But we have a yellow dot, so that's sort of the beginning step. And what you do then is you can face any which way when there's a yellow dot, and you're going to do the same method no matter what. You're going to do the face clock algorithm. So you're going to look at the face, you're going to spin it clockwise, then you're going to bring up the right side, and then you're going to spin the top clockwise, then you're going to bring down the right side, swivel back the top so that you have a white column, then you bring that down into place. And now we've made the yellow L that I was talking about. And when you have a yellow L, you want to actually orient it so one leg is facing you and one leg is facing to the right, the way it is now. So facing that way, you put this face towards you and you do that same algorithm, which is the face clockwise algorithm. You take the face, rotate it clockwise, bring up the right side, take the top and rotate it clockwise, then bring down the right side, swivel the top back so that you have this white column, and then put that back into place. So you see you have the white down on the bottom. And now we've created a yellow line. And now either facing it this way towards, as long as the horizontal is facing you, so either this way or this way. And then you're gonna do that same algorithm again. You're gonna do the face clockwise algorithm. So take the face, turn it clockwise, bring up the right side, swivel the top clockwise, bring down the right side, bring back the top, and then bring down your white column. And now you have a yellow cross. Now that we've made the next cross, the next step is to align the T's. And by that I mean you're going to rotate your top piece to align with the center, and you're going to make this so at least two of them line up. Like, so here we've got green and orange lining up, and then these two don't line up. So then in this situation, you're either going to put, you're going to put a good side on the back, and then you're going to either have a good side on the left like we do here, or else you'd have a good side on the front. So with a good side on the left, good side in the back, and with it facing towards you, you're going to do the right 180 algorithm. And so bring up the right, swivel the top 180 degrees, bring down the right, swivel the top back, bring up the right, swivel the top back, bring down that white column, swivel this into place, and now you've got all the T's created. So now the next step is placing the corners. So we're going to check the corners to see if they're the right colors. And you either have the situation where zero match, one matches, or all four. So let's check. This corner is orange and green, but we actually need it to be red and green, so that's no good. This one is blue and orange, but we need it to be blue and red, so that's no good. That one's not right, and neither is that. So we have four of them that are not right. So in that case, you can hold it in any direction, and you're going to do the lefty algorithm. So the lefty algorithm, you lift up the left side, swivel the top once, clockwise, then you bring up the right side, swivel back the top, bring down the white column, and then swivel the top back and bring down this white column. And then we swivel our T's to bring them aligned again. And now we check our corners, and still these corners are not the right colors. Oh, well, one now is the right color. So now when you have a good corner, you put that on the right, and you're going to do the lefty algorithm again. So bring up the left, swivel the top once, bring up the right, swivel the top back, bring down the left, swivel the top back, bring down the right, align the T's, and now you can check your corners. We have two that are perfectly right, and then these are the right colors, orange and blue, and this is the right color, red and green. So we've got the corners in the right place, and now we're ready to do the final step of solving the cube, which is to orient the corners. And what you do there is you bring a yellow face where it's a bad side and have it face the right. And if the cube facing you, you're going to do the right 180, left 180 algorithm. So the right 180 is the same one we did previously when we were aligning the T's. You're going to bring up the right, swivel the top 180 degrees, bring down the right side, swivel back, bring back up the right, swivel one more time. You've got your white column, bring that in place. Holding this constant, you bring up the left, swivel 180, bring down the left, swivel once, bring up the left, swivel one more time. You've got your white column. You rotate that down. And now we're going to face, we still have to solve these two sides. So we're going to face the yellow bad sides to the right. We're going to do the right 180, left 180 algorithms one more time. Bring up the right, swivel 180, bring down the right, swivel once. Bring up the right, swivel one more time, bring down the white column. Now do the same on the left. Bring up the left, swivel 180, bring down the left, swivel once, bring up the left, swivel one more time, bring down the left, and you have solved the cube.